guys. Welcome back to the Wood Metal Workshop. I'm Kent. Getting going here on the second half of the mill install. This is my electrician, Jim. Came over to give me a hand, walk me through this, and make sure that I got everything right on the first try. And he kind of took over the install and was doing it himself. So kind of neat talking to him, spending a little bit of time with him. He's been in the industry for over 40 years and a lot of good stories came out while we were working. So he's just getting the first three lines hooked up, or four lines. Got a ground in there as well. Using some 3/4 inch flex to make everything easy to run. And he's a master at cutting that flex. I just always struggle with it because I don't do it often enough. But he made it look easy. The directions that American Rotary sent were 100% clear and easy to follow and made wiring this up just a dream. And Jim's knowledge on doing this as cheaply as possible also was great. He decided we did not need a three-phase sub panel to hook everything to because the garage panel's 20 feet away across the shop. So. And in plain sight. So if you shut off the breaker there, everything shut off. Here we go, just feeding the lines around, and Jim's getting that hooked up. He said I was an excellent gopher, getting him everything he needed, so he didn't have to get up and down to wire this in. There it is, all wired up and plugged in. So we're going to give it our second try here. Jim just left, and here it was time to give it a shot. Stick isn't because I'm afraid, it's because I have a toolbox in the way and I can't quite reach it. So, just easier to reach there, in there with a stick and hit the buttons. Phase converter runs nice and quiet. Here we're going forward. Bump it into reverse here just to test that, make sure everything's working as it should. And there we go. So here we're testing out the power drive on the quill, power feed on the quill. It's got three speeds, 6, 3, and 1.5 thousandths per rev. So this is a 3, I believe. Also setting up the automatic stop for it. So it'll reach a certain point and stop and retract. You'll hear it click here. There it goes. Some S100 cleaner. And garagejournal.com, and a lot of scrubbing. Still a lot of scrubbing to do, but got a coolant and stuff. It's not right here. Just better than the acetone that I started. A little T-slot scraper. So I put some dicam on the end of an old putty knife and take one of the T-nuts, line it up on there and scribe around it, and then take it over to the grinder, and there we go. Scraping out the, and back to cleaning. Got the bottom of the base here. Fairly well cleaned. their residue. Just didn't want to take the hose to it and wash it off. Now we're gonna go ahead and go through an effort and frustration and getting the vise trammed in. Off camera, I checked the table to the head, and the head was already trammed pretty good. It was a couple of tenths off, and I just wasn't gonna mess with it. Here you can just tell I'm a novice because this took me forever. This is the first time I put a collet in there, and it was a little sticky, but after putting a couple different collets and cutters in there, it the drawbar freed up and much easier to do now. That's that new Noga holder I got for the dial test indicator, just for this process. Tell you, these Noga holders are great. I'm definitely going to be wanting some more of those. This isn't the best vise in the world, but it was the right price. It was came with the mill, so didn't cost me anything. Got my eyes open for a better one, but this one will work for now. Sorry to say, the card filled up before I had finished tramming this in, so you guys will miss the actual final, but I think I got it within, it's less than a thousandth out, so maybe 4 or 5 tenths. Took a while though. That was a lot of cranking that table back and forth just to get this set up right. Let me tell I'm a novice because I keep setting it back to zero so it's easier for me to read. Here we go. First test cuts. Got a 3/8 inch end mill in there and I'm just gonna buzz it off. We've got this footage is sped up so you guys don't have to wait for me to gingerly make my cuts. Go ahead and do the other end while we're here. This is just a piece that I bandsaw cut, just sitting on the bandsaw table with crap. Here's a good thing to do a test cut in, and I'm just going to make really light cuts just to kind of get a feel for the machine. Do a climb cut here just to do it actually. No real good reason. And I figured, well, one of the reasons I wanted a mill is so I could make slots on in metal, and well, might as well see if we can make a slot here. I'm gonna put a little dark cutting fluid on here, and you can tell that it makes tell it made a difference right away in the cut. So, plunge through, and then I went back about halfway in and take the first pass. Like I said, I just wanted to do light cuts, just testing it out, getting a feel for it. be much easier once I got the X power feed fixed for the new motor. The old one was frozen up. And if it wasn't burned out before I got to it, and I was messing around, I accidentally bumped the drum switch and didn't notice it until there was smoke coming out of the old motor. When I opened it up, there were a lot of chips inside of it. It was looks like it was fried before I got it. But it didn't start any fires, so that's good. You want to add a DRO to this mill, digital readout will make it much easier for a novice like me to work with. But that'll be a couple months away. Yeah. Budget's kind of blown for the moment. But there it is, all slot done. Here's the new motor for the X-axis. Came from eBay. Made the guy an offer and took him a couple of days and he accepted it. So I quickly paid him and he got it shipped out very, very quickly. And I had it less than a week later. And that's why this video didn't come out last weekend, was because I was waiting for this motor. And there we go. It's got three bolts and a stud. Used the stud first and just slipped a nut on. So hold the motor kind of in place while I got the three bolts started. There's two done. The third one was kind of hard to get at and get lined up, but eventually we got there. I always like to start them all before I tighten anything up. It seems to make everything easier. Sorry about sticking my big head in the way there. Put the cable clamp in and feed the wire through. Originally, the old motor had the wire connections on the back side of the motor from your view. So strip the wires here, and then we'll put some ring terminals on it. Crimp those on. Channel lock crimp tool. You can tell by the blue handles. These are nut and bolted together, or bolted together with a nut on the backside. So I'm just going to get these wired up per the diagram and back to using my 3M Scotch brand Super 33 electrical tape, my go-to tape for everything that's permanent. I'll use cheap stuff for wire pulling and that kind of stuff, but the Super 33 comes out when it's time to wrap up connections. It doesn't seem to get all gummy like cheap tape does. So last one there, get it taped up and yeah, stick my head in the way again. Go ahead and plug it back in and give it a test run. Nothing. Oh, wait. Okay, got to shift the knobs into gear so it actually does something. There we go. And of course, it's backwards. So get in here and untape two of them and switch the legs around, and all will be good with the world. When you push the lever to the right, table will go right. When you push the lever to the left, table will go left. Those three gray paddle switches there, they're the gearbox for the X-axis and allows you to change your feed speeds on the table. There's a little plate back on the knee that has that information on it. So I gotta get a copy of that, make a copy of it, and probably put it up on the head so I can actually see it. There we go. Going the right directions. All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you in the next video.